everybody! I'm Charlie, this is Go Theme Parks. Ray's here again.
I'm back.
We're at Legoland today. As you can see, there's a nice model here behind me. Unfortunately, I think that's probably the most exciting footage you're going to get today, but it's go time. We're here at Pirate's Cove at Legoland. Can't show you any of it, but there's a pirate ship over there, right? And when it goes, what it does, it swings backwards and forwards like that, right? And it's Lego themed, and there's some models over there. One's a pirate in front of a treasure chest, and there's a parrot, and then there's another pirate in a pirate ship, and there's a pirate in a barrel and a Lego dog. Right, I'm trying to be very descriptive for you guys here today.
And there's a log flume there.
Yeah, log flume is just over there. And then to our right here, there is face painting and caricatures and a refresh and refill station. So, yeah, we're gonna go and try and get some rides. We'll catch you in a bit. Okie dokie. So we're stood here in a little alcove next to a gate. It's good. There's nobody here. We can talk.
We can.
So we've been and we had a ride on Ninjago, didn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ray lost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So did Josh.
Yeah, Josh lost too. I beat both of them combined by 50,000 points.
I think I got about 51,000 something.
It means that, yeah, you got 55 and you got 48 and I got 155,700.
Yeah.
So yeah, we had pretty good fun on Lego Ninjago there. I'd say what it is with that one, what you got to do is you got to get the right rhythm going.
And there's sensors and you got to go like that.
Yeah, you got to go like that. You got to get the rhythm right, you see. If you're going too fast or too slow, then you're not getting the optimum amount of throwing stars out there. You know, there's like an optimum speed for getting the maximum amount of projectiles going, you know, so. I think that's what it is. Playing drums must help me out there, you know. Got that good timing.
Yeah.
That's what it is. That and my arms probably get less tired. Just used to it. But yeah, we had a ride on Lego Ninjago. We're going to go down, I think we're going to go on some other little dark shooty ride thing.
I can't remember the name of it. It's the shooting dark ride. Like,
yeah, well, this is Legoland. It's shooting dark ride. We're at Legoland. They've got about three, right?
300. I don't know if there's that many here.
At least the capacity is good, so it keeps the queues down anyway. So, yeah, anyway, guys, we will catch up with you in a little bit. Righty dokey. Right, we have got an Aero Nomad over here, which is like a big wheel thing. It's a bit like that one at Flamingo Land, except this one is
actually
moving.
Works.
Hand reveal.
Yeah, I would love a hand there. I would love to be able to show you a shot of it, but unfortunately we're at Legoland today, so we can't do that.
It's full of kids.
Yeah. So things are just gonna have to progress like this, guys. We'll keep going. But yeah, Ninjago, we're all right. We're going to get a ride on this thing, so...
Some sort of laser shooter thing.
Laser shooter thing. Lazy shooter.
I don't know.
They should make a boat ride one. The lazy shooter, like the lazy river. That'd be perfect. Stick them on rapids. Shoot stuff as you go around.
That'd be
combine
cool.
A rapids with a splash battle. Put the guns on the rapids.
Yeah.
And all the way around it. And then they can shoot at each other as they go around on rapids.
Yeah.
Yeah, I bet they're not allowed to do that, though, will they? Health and safety.
Yeah.
Or put some of them, put seats in it from the disco. You know what I mean? So you can see everybody facing out.
Yeah.
In the gondola.
And it's got the bar
The bar on the back. And then you put the guns, the water guns on the outside. And everybody's facing out and everybody, and they can all battle each other as they go around.
You should copyright this so Zampella's on top.
Hey, mate. You just heard me come up with that. right? If anybody comes out with that ride, I came up with that.
Looking at you, Merlin.
Merlin ain't got the gumption to put together a whole ride on their own. Come on.
That's Adventure Island that does them.
Yeah. Right. We'll catch up with you guys in a bit.
I hope I didn't.
Radio, here we are at Laser Raiders. This is the one that we're going to have a ride on. One of these shooting dark rides here at Legoland. We've actually managed to get a shot at the front of it. There's nobody here. Quick, Ray, say hello.
Hello.
There we go. Right, we're going to get on this. We'll catch up with you guys in a minute. So we are here inside of the Laser Raiders ride. There are some Lego things here. Can't see a lot of them, I'm sorry, but there are some Lego things there. But yeah, this is, it's got like some Egyptian theming going on here in Laser Raiders, shooting dark ride. Unfortunately though, so this does look like it could use a bit of a dust, doesn't it? Normally you wouldn't see that, but I'm really close up, so anyway, we're going to get a ride on here. I will catch up with you guys in a bit. Ratio, Ray, how long have we now been in this queue?
We have been in this queue so far 1 hour 8 minutes.
1 hour and 8 minutes. And must be 5 minutes, this way.
Yeah, 5 minutes.
An hour and 8 minutes. It runs incredibly, not just incredibly, but incredibly slowly does this ride. It seems to be, we're seeing that it seemed to move about once every 10 minutes. Apparently it's broken twice. I don't know if it only broke once, but they made an announcement that we're opening twice.
We can't show you, but there's engineering going past.
Yeah, there's four members of engineering just gone past.
There's a railway out this window.
Yeah, and there's a level crossing in the middle of queue line. That's weird. So, yeah, we're doing real well here at the minute.
There's no train coming.
No train. We're safe then.
Yep.
Right. We're nearly at the front. We'll see if we ever get out of this queue, won't we, Ray?
Yeah, might get out of it about 9:30 on Tuesday.
Tuesday, next week?
Yeah. It's Thursday today.
I'm supposed to be at work then.
Yeah.
That's not going to be any good. Right. We're going to try and get on this ride. And we'll see you in a bit. Okie dokie, Ray. So we've just been for a ride on Laser Raiders. It's sort of been in that queue so long that I've forgotten the name thing even. That wasn't good. Right, so, okay. So that first room, tough for every queue. Your queue then goes across a level crossing. So the staff come along partway through and start hunching people around in queue. Cross at level crossing. Like, seriously, Merlin, you have other parks. And they all have bridges over train bits like that, like when you go through Scorpion Express. Yeah, like, because why would you put the queue line through across the train?
There's one going on over there now, which you can't show because of those kids.
Well, I can't show that.
Let's talk about that ride itself.
You've got to just have this Legoland wall behind you. But yeah, well, the guns on that were absolutely atrocious. I'm there, I'm like shooting in one spot, and there's no consistency to my thing at all. It's going up and down and round like this.
Yeah, it's all over the shop.
Yeah, it's like normally on Duel, you can like sort of shoot and then zone in, can't you? You know what I mean? Like, oh, there, left a bit. Okay, got it now. On that, it don't matter, no, it's just all over the shop.
I've done a ghost train.
They have one gate, which is apparently for two cars, because they said it's two gates, but they're only loading one car at a time.
There's about five cars stacked up with nobody on.
Yeah, they're all stacked because...
It's just,
you know, Jewel's really old, right? Its ride system is actually better than
that. It's 30-year-old, the schedule.
May I just wait?
Because you can load people onto it.
Whilst it's moving?
Yeah, and it just keeps going, That's the idea. That is the idea of those kind of rides.
When it said 5 minutes outside and then it broke down twice, but all the 3-4 minutes, and then they said, oh, it's going to start back up.
And then 5 minutes later they said, oh, we're just starting back up now.
Yeah,
they started back up twice.
Said that twice, and then the queue started moving. It ended up being a 75-minute queue for a 3-minute ride.
I don't get how they've managed to make the antithesis of a shooting dark ride. The point of a shooting dark ride is, it's not that it's exactly a good ride, But it eats queues because it's supposed to keep moving and have good capacity, you know, like Jewel, that's the idea. It's rolling all the time, so stop on, hop off, never stops. It's constantly munching through a queue. That thing stops continuously. It's never munching through a queue.
Do you think that's munching through the time?
Yeah, all of our time. Right, we're going to go over here and have a look. Look at this area, and we'll catch up with you guys in just a sec. Okie dokie, we've made our way down to this area here, where there is a lighthouse and some water area. They do like the water show here. Just thought I'd get a shot of this, you know, so we've got a bit of B-roll where we can actually see some stuff. But yeah, we're going to go down, have a go at Dragon Coaster now, since we spent ages queuing for that ride. And we'll catch up with you in just a minute. Right, I'm in front here. I'm going to try and be quick. I'm going to hope nobody comes along so that I can vlog to you. We've made his way over here now to the Dragon Coaster. Ray's here again. And we're just going to go and get a ride on this. We spent a really ridiculously long time waiting for that. And now I think I'm going to have to cut this before anybody comes along. I will catch up with you guys in a minute. Rightio, Ray. So we went, we had ourselves a ride on the Dragon Coaster, which, yeah, I'd say that weren't bad.
It's probably the best ride in the park. Well, that one doesn't say much, does it?
It probably is the best ride in the park. Yeah, a little dark ride bit at the start's quite nice. You've got some wizards, you've got a dragon, you've got some people.
100 times better than whatever that laser thing was.
Yeah, that laser thing
weren't
good. Laser Raider weren't good. But the worst thing about it is, why is it loaded so slowly? Once again, I know I said this earlier, but it's like you got a shooting dark ride. It's supposed to eat cues. Go ask John Wardley. Right? That one doesn't, so what's the purpose of it? I don't get it. I was working it out. It's like, so at the minute that ride's operating maybe an out throughput of 200 people an hour.
If you look
from what I was observing there. I mean, I didn't get the stopwatch out to properly work it out, but I mean, I had a quick tot up and yay, it seemed like about 200 people an hour, which in a place like Legoland makes no sense. None whatsoever. But anyway, we're on about Dragon Coaster, weren't we? Let's stop getting sidetracked by other things.
It's a fantastic coaster, the Dragon Coaster.
Dragon Coaster's good, nice little dark ride bit. It's got a strange turn on that bit before it comes back into the station.
Yeah,
That's a bit weird.
It's a bit weird.
I wasn't expecting a double lift hill.
No.
Yeah, double lift, two lift special. So yeah, we say Dragon Coaster, probably best ride in the park so far. So yeah, we're going to go have a ride and say, I think we're going to go try and go on Log Flume. And because we didn't get on the Log Flume yesterday, kept breaking. Luckily, we out me on it this time. But yeah, we're going to go and try and get a ride on something over there, and we'll catch up with you guys in a little bit. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, for another edition of Go Theme Parks Wildlife Watch. And today here at Legoland, we have a robin. I'm going to try and get a little closer. I don't want him to go away. I just want to get a better shot. Look at him. He's an happy robin here at Legoland. Right. So we went. We were going to have a ride on Log Flume.
We were.
Just as we got there, guess what?
It broke down.
Broke down. Always happens. Why is it? Whenever I go anywhere, the log flumes break. So yesterday, Chessington, log flume broke. Last time I were at Chessington, log flume broke. With me on it. Here, log flume broke. Right as we were going to get on it. Go.
Before that, it was 55 minutes.
Well, it was 35 minutes, then it went to 55 minutes, and then it went to broke.
You can't trust the queue times in this place.
It's like, you know,
5 minutes for the radio ride.
It's like we're going fast, we've gone to ludicrous speed, we've gone to plaid, that one went to broke. Right. So we're going to go and have a ride on the madhouse, because we like a good madhouse,
don't we?
We like a good madhouse. And yeah, maybe if we're lucky, Lovelo might come back on. I don't know, it depends on time, doesn't it? So yeah, we'll get a ride at madhouse. We'll let you know what it's like, and we'll catch up with you in a bit. Right, we've just been for a ride on the
Monster House Party.
Monster House Party.
Haunted.
Madhouse.
Madhouse.
The Madhouse. That's not bad. I'm quite good. It's a bit jerkier than some I've been on.
Yeah, I've only ever done Haunting and Hex.
I don't know if that's meant to sync up with music though, because it felt like it were trying to.
It was jerking as the music was going.
Trying
on,
so to go to the music.
Making you want to have a bite.
We noticed something funny though, there's like watermarks on the roof, isn't there?
Yeah.
And the rider passed what we were looking at, he's like, alright guys, what's up? And we were like, oh, we're just looking at these marks on the roof. We were like trying to work out if they were a leak or if like the UV paint had run or something. And we were like, oh no, what happens is now and again somebody will drop a drink and it just sort of goes down into the ride mechanism, and then when it goes upside down it just goes everywhere. So yeah, if you see any weird marks on the walls on the madhouse, that's what it is, somebody dropped the pop. Right, we're going to go and have a go on Mythica, because that's pretty new, isn't it?
And we've got like 9, 8 minutes.
Yeah, we'll manage it.
Last
right, we'll get down there, we'll catch up with you guys in a bit. Right, yeah, we've just been for a ride on the Mythica Flying Theatre, which is like Lego's version of Soarin', and it's got a griffin and that in there, and that's a really good ride, actually.
Best thing here.
Yeah, I'm going to agree
definitely
with that.
100%. That's
best ride here, Mythica, best ride here. Does it have three films? I don't know if it has three films. There's three portals. If it's got three films, I would be really impressed by the fact that they've gone to that attention to detail to bother to make three of them, because that would cost them more. Merlin spent 50p on guest experience.
That's amazing, that.
Merlin spent money on guest experience.
Oh, guess what?
When the last time happened? I mean, definitely before COVID.
Yeah.
Definitely been at least 3 years.
They need to spend 50 pence and actually open the chip shop.
Or finish that wall.
Merlin could really use opening more of the food outlets generally. I mean, you go in. I always think, you know, when they're building a new ride and they build three food outlets outside of it, and I always think, could have saved yourself some money, guys, and not built them, because you'd never open them. You never, when what last time you saw something other than the coffee place open in Forbidden Valley?
Very rare.
Very rare.
I've seen Burger Kitchen up.
Maybe on a peak, really peak day. Like Scarefest or fireworks, like when there's an event on, maybe. But other than that, they're all always closed.
Well, even when there's an event on.
Well, yeah, it's a good point. I have seen them closed a lot, even when the. I mean, the other day at Fort, hot day, oh, ice cream stalls were shut. Like, that's the.
And the slush bars.
Slush bars were shut. They had a slushy cocktail bar, not open. Like, surely your best time to be selling some ice creams and some frozen cocktails and some slushies on the day when it's 40 degrees, innit? It's got to be. But, right. Mythica. Best ride here, I'd say.
Definitely.
I like that. I really like the theme as well, about imagination. It's imagination. Rarely do you hear me wax lyrical about a dart ride or anything like that, you know.
Yeah.
But, that great theme. Love that theme. It's great. It's about imagination. Imagination can transform the world, which is true, because imagination's been transforming the world forever. Otherwise, you wouldn't have Legoland. Nobody had ever built it. You wouldn't have music. You wouldn't have films. When somebody one day said, oh, yeah, I can make a device that'll record pictures and play them back and they'll move, and everybody looked at that bloke and thought he were crazy. But guess what? He could imagine it, and he could build it, and he did. And that's what makes the world go around. You can imagine it, you can build it. One day we'll be able to do like Star Trek stuff, you know? Probably not in my lifetime, but one day. But anyway, we're gonna go, I think we're gonna get a little ride at Lego Express or something, finish off. I wanna get out of here before 6 o'clock when it shuts, because I don't wanna be stuck in that mega queue on the way out, because the queue out of Legoland is insane. Like you're doing half a mile in an hour. So, yeah. We're going to get over there, aren't we?
Yeah.
Right, we'll catch you guys in a little bit.
Oh dear mateys, we got the hungry troll here, look. And he likes his fish and chips. And he's got all his chips. And you can't have none.
Right guys. So now we're down here at the bottom of the park. We're near the chip shop. The chip shop is over there. And Hydra is over there. and there's a big Lego model of a Hydra over there, right? And then there's a kid's play area here with like a helter skelter, and Mythica's over there, down that pathway, and there's the fire and ice drop tower right about there. It's quite a nice area. I mean, this bit's all painted up sort of like a dragon here, this helter skelter. And then you got all the Hydras here, there's blue. I mean, some nice colours going off on that Hydra model over there. Love to get a shot of it for you, but I don't think I can at the moment. So, yeah. Righto, everybody, we have made it to the end of another day. We have been here at Legoland. I don't know if I could call it fantastic, because there were definitely some bits that were subpar.
Rubbish.
Yeah, crap.
That's clean.
Laser Raiders.
Level diarrhea.
When's it start?
When's it start? I don't know.
Where's it start?
But yeah, luckily though, as Dave did pick up right at the end there, I would say Legoland has been saved today by the strength of Mythica here, because I would say that is, by a margin, my favourite ride in the park. Rare do you hear me wax lyrical about simulator rides or dart rides and stuff. I do like them. I do like them. You just got to get the right one, right? And I like this. I like seeing the imagination. Like I was saying earlier about imagination, imagination is important. Imagination changes the world. Always has done, always will do. That's how we build new ideas.
They just need to work on laser raiders for that one.
Ah, yeah. Why doesn't it load more cars at once? I don't get it. I don't get it. It's like somebody designed that ride and went, I've got 2 feet. I'm going to shoot myself in this one. That's what that bloke did. Why? Right, anyway, but yeah. No, okay, we did actually, other than the fact that we keep hating on Laser Raiders because we waited a really long time.
25 minutes.
Yeah, for a really disappointing ride. And it was weird. It was weird. There's things in Legoland, about Legoland, that are a bit weird, actually, to be honest. A couple of them, but I might process my thoughts and try and put this all into one video at some point later on. But yeah, from us guys here, at Legoland, with the fantastic Mythica, right, we've had a great day, we'll see you later, and remember, as always, secure your dummies.
Thank you for watching today's video. If you enjoyed it, drop me a like and a comment. And if you want to see more of my stuff, then you could check out my channel and subscribe and hit the bell.